As of June 11, 2023, there are currently 45 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet. One of these erupting volcanoes is the Popocatepetl volcano in Mexico, which, after a several week-long period of increased ash emissions, finally dropped back to a lower alert level of yellow phase 2. With this being said, here are this week's major volcano-related news stories. In Alaska, the alert level of the Iliamna volcano, which had not erupted in 90 years, was temporarily raised from green to yellow due to a suspicious series of earthquakes which quickly became more and more frequent. Meanwhile, in the Philippines, the potentially dangerous Mount Mayon volcano produced a brand new eruption, causing lava avalanches and pyroclastic flows to descend up to 2.8 kilometers or 1.74 miles down its flanks. And, in what is this week's top story, the Hawaiian island chain once again became the site of a volcanic eruption as, after a 93-day-long period of not erupting, the Kilauea volcano erupted anew. For some context, the Kilauea volcano is the youngest of four active volcanoes which make up the Big Island of Hawaii, having been erupting intermittently for 250,000 years. These eruptions have in recent years largely occurred within Kilauea's large caldera, which is known as Hale Mau Mau, and the eruption which started is no different. As, on the morning of June 7, 2023, at 4:44 a.m. local time, a body of lava burst through the caldera floor of Hale Mau Mau, starting a new eruption. Since the initial burst had a moderate amount of associated gas, it temporarily created a lava fountain which reached up to a height of 216.77 meters or 711.19 feet. However, as the volatile content in the erupting lava decreased, so did the height of generated lava fountains. Additional fissures thereafter opened up on its caldera floor, dividing the supply of erupting molten rock. By an hour later, 1.5 square kilometers had been covered in a layer of fresh lava. Lava effusion during this period averaged approximately 150 cubic meters per second, although this value has decreased over time. One vent even opened up on the wall of the caldera's downdraft block, which formed in 2018, slowly building a new spatter cone, courtesy in this footage of the Two Pineapples YouTube channel. This eruption, in my opinion, is likely to continue for several more weeks at a minimum. In Alaska, an unusual earthquake swarm began at the Iliamna volcano, which is 136 miles southwest of the city of Anchorage. Iliamna has not erupted since 1933, but due to its proximity to Anchorage and Homer, any eruption from it would likely generate ashfall in those cities. Around noon local time on June 5th, an increase in seismic activity was observed beneath the volcano. Earthquakes occurred in 1-minute intervals and over time became more closely spaced. As a result, Iliamna's alert level was temporarily raised from green to yellow the same day at 4:53 p.m. local time, as these quakes could be caused by either the movement of magma, hydrothermal fluids, a slow-moving landslide, or a large avalanche. However, further analysis 170 minutes later revealed that the signal, which stopped around 5:14 p.m. local time, was caused by a fairly large ice rock avalanche that occurred on Iliamna's Red Glacier, and its alert level was lowered back to green as seismic activity returned to background levels. This avalanche is not all that surprising, considering that the eastern summit region of Iliamna is highly altered and contains several fumaroles. And, in the Philippines, the situation at the Mayon volcano, which has produced more distinct eruptions than any other volcano in the country since 1900, has rapidly escalated. A new cycle of summit ground uplift began on May 4th of 2023, and beginning on June 4th, sections of the volcano's lava dome emplaced in 2018 began tumbling down its steep slopes as it was being pushed upwards by shallow magma. This caused Mayon's alert level to be raised from 1 to 2 on the 0 to 5 alert level scale at 10 a.m. local time on June 5th. Yet, only 2 days later, 4 larger scale rockfalls occurred, causing fresh volcanic gas to be released from the volcano alongside pyroclastic flows, which traveled up to a distance of 2 kilometers. This seemingly marks the exact time Mayon officially began a new volcanic eruption, as soon after on noon of June 8th, its alert level was raised from 2 to 3. Numerous reports followed as fresh lava and a distinct orange glow became visible on Mayon's summit. This material then occasionally tumbled downslope, creating lava avalanches. As of June 10th, much of Mayon's 2018 lava dome has been removed and scattered around the summit region via rockfalls, which have already occurred, and a new 440-foot-wide and 100,000-cubic-meter lava dome has been constructed. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on June 10th of 2023. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.